Hello Cloud Lovers, how y'all doing? I'm excited today to share with you my experience about the AWS Cloud Practitioner Certification so you can in your turn pass the exam. Let's go! You are new in AWS, you are a recruiter who wants to better understand what his cloud engineers are doing, or you just want to prove that you have a general understanding of AWS, this certification is for you. In this video, we will talk about why would you take this exam, what you will need to validate to pass the exam, how can you prepare yourself to pass it, and we will also review some sample questions. So why would you take this exam? Well, I will start by giving you a number, $130,000. This is the average salary for an AWS certified engineer. It's a beautiful number, right? But it depends on the country. Cloud computing in general has grown exponentially in the past few years and is expected to keep growing in the coming years. Actually, many companies are moving all the data from their data centers to the cloud. This shows us clearly that the future of the cloud computing is bright. And having this certification will be the first step for you to enter in the AWS certified family, and you can then go further to pass other certifications depending on which area you want to specialize. You can do the associate's level, the professional, or even the specialty certification. Google Trends graph show that AWS specific jobs are rising compared to other IT jobs. So putting this certification on your resume will make it really attractive for recruiters. You will also be a force of proposal and will not be a gate during some meetings where it talks about AWS. I will give you a scenario. You are in a meeting with your boss and he says that he has a problem. He wants to store a huge amount of file in AWS and he don't know if it is possible. And because you learn and pass the AWS Cloud Practitioner, you will be capable to tell him yes, it's possible. There is a service on AWS called Simple Storage Services where he can store his data, create lifecycle policies, and even more. Now let's talk about what you will need to validate to pass the exam. The exam will cost you actually $100 and the duration is 90 minutes. It includes 65 questions with multiple choices and multiple answer format. The exam is broken down into four domains: the cloud concepts, the security, the technology, and the billing and pricing. In order to pass the exam, you need to be able to demonstrate your abilities to define what the AWS cloud is and the basic global infrastructure, to describe key services on the AWS platform and their common use cases. You need to understand basic security and compliance aspects of the AWS platform and the shared security model. You need to also define the billing, account management, and pricing models. Understand basic AWS cloud architectural principles. Be capable to identify source of documentation or technical assistance, for example, white papers or support tickets. And finally, describe basic core characteristics of deploying and operating in the AWS cloud. All this may seem a lot, but I assure you guys, it's very easy to handle it. So how can you prepare yourself to pass it? AWS offers for the certification a free digital training. I will put the link in the description so you can directly register to it. It's not a long course, it lasts only 6 hours and treats all domains that I mentioned earlier. You also need to study AWS white papers. There are documentation writing by AWS teams, independent analysts, and AWS partners. I will give you also in the descriptions PDF links of 4 white papers you need to focus on. So for the certification, you don't really need to take courses on AWS Guru or Linux Academy because you already have the official courses of AWS. Concerning services that came out during the exam, we can't say that there are many services you need to deep dive in it. Just make sure to know what does all services they mention in the official courses in the high level. And after, you can do now some practice tests. And for that, there's a website called wislab.com where you can find 195 questions for the Cloud Practitioner Exam. It will cost you $15. Make sure to go through all the questions at least twice. And for close all your revisions, you can take the official online practice test of AWS where they simulate the real environment of the exam. This one will cost you $20. I will give you also the link in the description so you can directly register to it. And after passing all these steps, I'm sure that you will be confident and you just have to go and smash the exam. The day D, just read carefully the questions. They are not difficult. Let's see what type of question you will have. So guys, I'm now opening the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner sample exam questions. I will put the link for you in the description so you can directly download it. Now let's review the question number 3. Which AWS offering enables customers to find, buy, and immediately start using software solutions in their AWS environment? A. AWS Config. B. AWS OpsWork. C. AWS SDK. D. AWS Marketplace. The correct answer for this one is D. AWS Marketplace. As you see, the questions are not too long and they are very simple. So that's it, guys. This was my recommendation to take the AWS Certified Practitioner Exam. It's an easier certification in AWS, and if you follow my study guide, you will have a lot of chance to smash it with a high mark. If you want to pass the AWS Security Specialty, you can click right here to watch my feedback video about this exam. If you have any question, please let me know in the comments or send me an email at contact@osiriscloud.com. Don't forget to subscribe and may the cloud be with you.